Welcome to Arts District. I'm your host, Carrie Saldo. The start of a typical day for Denver-based photographer Suzanne Heintz goes like this. Husband Chauncey lies on the living room floor, dismembered. She, unmoved, applies makeup nearby. But this is not the scene of a grisly crime. Chauncey is a mannequin. That's true for two-thirds of Heintz's fictional family, which she's been both party and witness to, photographing their vacations, breakfasts, and even steamy shower scenes. It's all for a project that she calls Life Once Removed.
You bought an actual engagement ring?
It's cubic zirconia.
There you go.
I'm not crazy.
14 years ago, when you started the project, what was the intent, if you can think back? What was the intent then?
To get back at everyone, frankly. It was because at that time, all of my friends were getting married and having kids, and I was the odd man out. And everywhere I went, people just kept asking me, why aren't you married? Oh, you're so cute, you're so funny. I can't see why you don't have a man. And that just didn't sit with me right. So when my own mother put it to me point blank, there's nobody perfect out there. You're just gonna have to pick somebody if you want to settle down. I yelled back at her and I said, Mom, it's not like I can go out and buy a family. I can't just make this happen.
But you could buy someone.
I did make it happen. All by myself. I went out and bought him. And I also bought our daughter at the same time. It was sort of a light bulb moment. I was walking past a retail liquidation outlet center and they were selling their mannequins in the window. And I saw this perfect family and I thought, I can just go in and plunk down my credit card and buy a family and make this happen in one day. I was in photography school at the same time and I thought, this is the perfect semester long project. I'm just going to take Kodak moments with my perfect family. Initially, I started very simple, just family shots around the household. But my girlfriends talked me into taking them on our first road trip to one of those American roadside attractions, Carhenge. But when we got there, people started watching us set up, and I saw the reactions. People would just laugh out loud, and they'd wonder what I was doing, and they'd come up and talk to me. And at that time, I realized, wow, this is a perfect opportunity to explain my point, and I can get feedback, too, from the viewer, rather than hanging in a gallery and never hearing back, or that, you know, a viewer can never ask questions of the artist. So I thought this was a great interface. Get there, I don't really know what's gonna happen, but I have a general concept. So I frame up the camera on sticks and kind of know what I'm going for.
Okay, pull that corner towards me.
And then I let a little bit of reality happen. I let people pass behind me. And, you know, I improvise as I do these odd, over-the-top facial expressions. And I take well over 500 photos, usually. And I just pick one that's the most picture perfect.
Why the 1950s?
It's related to why I call this whole project Life Once Removed. A family relation that's one generation apart is called Once Removed. Well, so is our relationship to the image we have of our life. You know, it comes from the generation before us. I grew up in your perfect suburban family that came out of the 1950s, you know, and sort of the Ozzie and Harriet look. And so I just think it speaks to how antiquated this concept is, that we still are trying to maintain a family image that is 50, 60 years old. A lot of people think that I'm anti-family or anti-marriage, and that is so not the case. I just think you need to do it in the right time for the right reasons, and not just do it because you're running out of time and your eggs are getting old.
Australia, France, Brazil, Germany, Canada, Denmark, Japan, Poland, The Huffington Post, Yahoo, over a million hits on the trailer, the movie version of it. Why do you think, I mean, you've been doing this for 14 years, why do you think in the last several months this has become so huge?
I think social media has become our substitute postcard. And so we start projecting an image of what we want people to think about our lives. We get some strokes and feedback through Facebook, but it's not genuine human interaction. I think it starts distancing ourselves from our true nature. This is what I look like as opposed to what I feel like. This is who I am.
Try not to touch the microphone.
Thank you.
You are a very funny person. Is that where the humor came for you? Or did you make a conscious decision to say, you know, if I go about this in a very direct way that's driven by social commentary, it might be harder for people to hold on to? Is that why you use satire?
Yes. I started in a darker, more serious place when I did the first test shots of this. And I didn't think it was very effective. It was kind of gloomy. It evolved into a humorous satire on the whole subject. And I think that's much more effective. By making them laugh and startling them, that's the way to open up the conversation. It takes an incredible amount of drive to make this really come together, but I think it's all part of the aesthetic and why I think it makes it into a stronger statement. I want to have a conversation with my viewer. I want them to be drawn to what I'm saying and then want to listen and to walk away with something that's tangible and concrete, understandable, and relatable to their own life. So that's why I use video and photography, because I think it's the medium that is most understandable for most people.
Not every husband gets a wife who works as hard for him.
Watch your head, buddy. He is wearing a helmet.
They truly are props for me. I don't view them with any human qualities. I keep them in a box in the basement. I don't eat breakfast with them. Just in the photos, you know, it's all for show. And that's really the point of the project. If we are concentrating on the image of what our lives should look like, we're not concentrating on the feeling of contentment that we truly want in our lives. You know, it's all about image versus reality. And I touched my microphone, I'm sorry.
I'm Carrie Saldo. Like us on Facebook, follow me on Twitter, join our newsletter, and come back here to our studio next week.
Arts District is a collaboration between Rocky Mountain PBS and public radio stations KUVO and KVJZ.